recently knocked down the house, which, by the way, Rotten Tomatoes gave 100% to, was nice. Released on Netflix. And it was a wonderful documentary about AOC and other women who ran for Congress. These are average Americans who were sick of the system and they wanted to fight and they wanted to run. Now, in the documentary, we see AOC's boyfriend. And I gotta be honest, I was surprised at who her boyfriend is, just keeping it 100. You know, you hear about boyfriends and you have all these thoughts in your head. And anyway, I'm gonna stop talking before I get myself in trouble. Riley Roberts is his name. He's insanely supportive. Like, you watch it and it brings you to tears, like watching their relationship, how supportive he is. He's there by her side throughout the entire thing. And then all of a sudden you get the reactions on social media, right? And here's one of those reactions. Marie Le Conte, who's a journalist, tweeted this and later deleted. Apologies for the blatantly mean tweet, but this is what AOC's boyfriend looks like. Incredible scenes truly representing all the ambitious and stunning millennial women shackled to boyfriends who look like bin raccoons out there. Okay,
so can
you understand why she later deleted that? That was crazy.
What is a bin raccoon?
It's a bin is a trash can, so it's a raccoon that's been rooting through the trash.
Don't they all? He's
got a little stuff in his fur. He's got like
don't
stuff
they in all?
Food, like a little piece of the one salami piece hanging right down here.
Yeah,
it's a bin raccoon.
Look, and I want to tell you what my own like thoughts were. It had nothing to do with how attractive he is or whatever. Okay. I like everyone's in their own bubbles or in their own heads, and I have a thing clearly for Latino men. So for some reason I just assumed that she would be with a Latino guy, and I was surprised that he wasn't Latino. That's it. That was the only surprising part of it. But people are on social media just openly talking about how ugly they think he is, and it's insane. And how like that she's shackled to him. Did you watch the documentary?
Oh, yeah, that
was so great to her.
Yeah. Right.
It was such a great relationship.
Yeah.
So I'm gonna give you AOC's response to all of this in a minute, but Steve Bermucci, I love saying your last name.
I built it up too much.
Yeah, you have some strong thoughts on this.
Here's what I think. Here's my big thought of the day. I think that journalism historically suffers from a dominant and misogynist patriarchy. And I think that that misogynist patriarchy set a pattern of talking smack about how people who were espoused or dating political candidates looked. And I think that's a terrible thing that male journalists did for decades.
Yes.
But I don't think using the same technique is cool. I think that this woman who is an accredited journalist and is a real journalist talking smack and making this story go viral. This is just a 30-year-old dude who thinks his girlfriend's hot and would like to continue that relationship and would rather not have his whole spot blown up on the internet. I respect that for him. I wish he had had that without all this. That said, as I'm sure you're about to explain, AOC's response was incredibly charming and cool, like she always is.
Yeah,
I think social media has created this space where people forget that some conversations are really just for your friends.
Yeah.
100%.
I'm not gonna sit here and act like I think everybody is just nice all the time.
Right.
But like, girl, you could have said that to your homegirl.
Yes. Right.
That did not need to go on your work account on the internet. That was mean. You knew it was mean. You said it was mean.
Yes,
it was inappropriate. And then it was like inappropriate like 10 different ways. Like, where are your friends? I think about that all the time. Where are your friends?
Yeah,
like that is
a good takeaway from this.
I mean, the tweet was deleted, so there's no timestamp on it, but it could have been like a late night tweet. You know, she just finished watching the documentary and thought it was a good idea to put that out there.
I just think it's tricky. Like, the guy's a private citizen. It's just, you know, next time he goes into a room with his beautiful, charming, extremely talented, powerful girlfriend, he's gonna be like, oh, I got that bin raccoon thing in the back of my head and the 50 memes I saw about myself.
No, he's not, because of everything you just said before you said girlfriend, he is living the life, whatever.
You think he's gonna be good? Okay,
like,
well then forget it.
Like, not even
you might be
worried,
right.
Okay?
Good, maybe it's just about me. I need to get better at brushing things off. I think if one of your viewers calls me a bin raccoon, I'm gonna stew about it for a month and a half. All right, okay, you've taught me a life lesson. Forget it, it's fine, French journalist. Call whoever you want a bin raccoon, you're good.
All right. Okay, let me compose myself. So there was, of course, a response on Twitter. Before we get to AOC's, I thought this was funny. So someone wrote the following: apologies for the blatantly mean tweet, but this is what her boyfriend looks like. And
so
it's
funny.
A photo of Cersei Lannister and Bolton. Euron Greyjoy. Why did I think Bolton?
It's okay.
That's so
I
weird.
Mean, they look
yeah,
alike.
Euron Greyjoy and Cersei Lannister. Apologies for the blatantly mean tweet, but this is what her boyfriend looks like. Incredible scenes truly representing all the ambitious and stunning millennial women shackled to boyfriends who look like bin raccoons out there. And then just a quick screenshot from the actual documentary, which look, the important takeaway from this is you should watch the documentary
yes.
because it was incredible. But the screenshot shows what her boyfriend looks like, and he looks 100% fine. Like there is nothing wrong with the way he looks. And AOC responded to some of this stuff by saying this on Twitter. We were so ready for lumberjack life after months of 18-hour days that neither one of us had gotten a haircut in months. It's also one reason why my hair was always in a bun. It was very nice to see him again after we took a weed whacker to his castaway beard post-election. So he apparently did some grooming after the election, and I think he looks exactly the same. And don't change the way you look because people are, you know, not nice. I don't think he did it because of that, but he looked totally fine. The only thing that was surprising to me was that he was like a redhead white guy. Like I just didn't expect that, you know?
I mean, one of the most poppin' congresswomen ever right
yeah,
now thinks
yeah.
he's fine. Like whatever, who
you know
cares?
Why he's fine?
You're right.
What,
you know,
he's so great to
right.
her.
Riley, listen to this. You're fine, you're good. Don't sweat it, brush it off. You have a great beard, we like it. We like it. You look like a 15th century pirate and we're so for it.
I can't.
In a good way, I love pirates.
I tried.
I liked, that was a compliment. backfired, sorry.
Have you ever grown out your beard?
I can't. My father in Italy is actually called La Barba, which means the beard because his beard was so big. And I just can't do it. I'd like to be a bin raccoon. I'd like to get to that place.
Oh my goodness.
I'm gonna cover these features up.
Who tweets apologies for this blatantly mean tweet and then tweets
and
it?
And then tweets it immediately.
Literally everyone
their
on Twitter does that. That's what everyone
what?
Does.
That's true, you're
Our
right.
Our president,
no,
I don't
right.
know.
You're right, you're
he doesn't
you're
even
right.
apologize for his blatantly mean tweets.
You're right, you're right.
Like what you see, click the subscribe button below and don't forget to ring the bell to never miss another video from the Young Turks.